Evening and in the presence of these friends and I'm sure also loved ones. I tonight you Arne, Jessica, and Mary. And your family and your friends are here to be with you and to rejoice with you in the making of this most important commitment. And marriage is a commitment to life. Because I am sure through your courtship, Arne, Jessica, you have become each other's best friends, teachers, and listeners. Lovers, confidants, and maybe even occasional critics. And as you know, no minister nor public official can marry you, for only you can marry yourselves. And now, by that mutual commitment to love one another, to always work together towards creating an atmosphere of care, respect, and consideration, and by a willingness to face those tensions and anxieties that will underlie life, you can make your lives, but especially your wedded life, come alive. Mr. Arne, Jessica, Arne, I'm going to ask of you to stay closer together than ever before. And you should love one another in sickness and in health, and for better or for worse. But at the same time, that very precious love which you have found and nurtured together should give you that strength to stand apart, to seek out your unique destinies, and to make those special contributions to the world, which is always a part of us. This evening, as you join yourselves in marriage, there is a vast and an unknown future that will stretch out before you, and the possibilities and potential of your wedded life are now great. And now falls upon your shoulders that task of choosing values and making real those dreams which you have strived for. And again, in this way, you'll not only create the meaning of your lives, but most importantly, your wedded life. Meredith, I believe you have a reason for it too.
Will you, ask the little scarlet leaf? I will, said the little yellow leaf. And 1, 2, 3, they let go and soared.
Thank you very much. Gentlemen, I believe there are two very special couples of love this evening in the Passion of Women. I want you to pause for just a moment and look at your rings and notice those inner bands are perfect circles. Those are circles without ending, as your love shall always be for each other. They're also made of a very precious material, as precious as this evening is for you, and shall remain that way for eternity. And Arne, if you'll please place that ring for our man Jessica's left hand. As you have Jessica's hands in yours, please, if you'd repeat after me. I, Arne, take you, Jessica.
I, Arne, take you, Jessica.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
Better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
Richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Today, tomorrow, forever.
Today, tomorrow, and forever.
I, Jessica, take you, Arne.
I, Jessica, take you, Arne.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
Better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Today, tomorrow, Laura, Jessica, as your rings tell each of us present this evening here at 8,500 feet, that your two lives have now been joined into one unbroken circle. And wherever you may go, may you always return to one another in your togetherness. May the home which you'll establish be such a place that often shall be found family and friends. And may the rings which you've just placed on each other's hands always symbolize the touch of spirit of beloveds in each of your hearts. In the scriptures, it wrote and it spoke of love as being patient and kind. It's not jealous, boastful, or proud. And love is not ill-mannered, nor selfish, nor irritable. Will it ever keep a record of wrong? It doesn't like evil, but it does rejoice with the truth. Love shall never fail you, for it has three very distinct virtues, that of faith, hope, and patience. And those virtues are never ending, for love is eternal. And then as much as you, Arne, Jessica, have consented this evening in marriage, you have declared your faith in the unity. By the giving and receiving of your rings and by the exchanging of your vows, I, in accordance with the state of California, the state of Nevada, and the authority vested in me through the states, gives me the honor to pronounce you husband and wife. In just a moment, Arne, Jessica, I'm going to send you off on this journey, a little pristine evening to begin with. But before, we'd like to leave you with a very special blessing from the native inhabitants of this land. And Grandma, would you please join us? Yes.
And now, you will feel no rain, for each of you will be the shelter for each other. Now, you will feel no cold, for each of you will be the warmth for each other. Now, you are two persons, but there is only one life before you. Go now to your dwelling place to enter into the days of your life together. And may your days be good and long upon the earth. Amen. Sorry. Tahoe. Fill your mouths with a kiss.
Refreshments are on the way, please.